Hello and welcome to Supreme Commander Forge Alliance. This is another classic settings. This is early 2010, so kind of the golden age of settings, you could say. This is when people first began to figure out what the heck is going on, and could probably actually compete with today's players. But we'll see what happens in the middle. We got a TX1000. Haven't seen him for a long time, but played quite a few settings game. We got Mama-san. Used to lag like crazy, but was actually a very good player. Going with Seraphim in the middle. So we got a YF Seraphim battle, and here we got Killer 1351. This is the good killer. Well, I can say the best killer. You might know him as Jaguar in more recent games. He'll play extremely well. He's got Berg on his side as well, Cybern and YF here in the back, and Foley BTS. He's gonna be taking on Ukulele. He's playing as Aeon. And also Eco-7 versus Berg, Aeon, and Flying Kangaroo. So really the big naval matchup here, Flying Kangaroo with Killer are gonna show us the best of Navy from early 2010. So you can see both players know to run to the middle. The point defense is still used. Looks like it is gonna be from the ACU from TX1000. No point defense for Mama-san. Remember there was a debate for a while, point defense or no point defense, and people would call point defense noob. And now it seems like it's pretty clear what to do. But this is really early NG for Mama-san. Actually, it looks like two point defenses, an engineer that's going to get mass extractors and eventually try to get the point defense. I am willing to bet this one will not be successful. Mama-san now, actually, oh, Mama-san going with the point defense as well. So we'll see who gets this first. But this is a lot like Mr. White. Mr. White used to do this exactly in this position. And TX 1000 too late. And this is going to be a big prize for the top side. They're going to get a lot of mass. And Mech Marine's also running through, of course, tanks for Mama-san. A single Mech Marine gets through. Still an engineer in position to get a little bit of mass for Mama-san. Looks like Killer able to take his island, and not too much of a challenge from Flying. Flying for the most part just decking. Eco-7, really quick air, so going to tech 2, although it's already coming up a minute 6, gonna try to get a tech to NG. And Mama-san putting TX in quite a bit of pressure here. And a challenge now for the island, Ukulele versus Foley. The factory has already been built, it's making flak. It shouldn't be making flak, it's gonna make Auroras. But four Manti are gonna decimate Auroras in close range. So it looks like the Manti will be successful unless they keep on shooting at the factory, which kind of inexcusable now. Finally they start doing the right thing. But a bomber now from Ukulele. And looks like Ukulele will be able to keep his island. So pretty close, but that's going to be a big disadvantage for Foley, who is now making some Tech 1 Navy. We're also seeing Tech 1 Navy for Ukulele. Two rock players, best ecos. And a YEF for Killer. Really doesn't matter though, since naval mixing was allowed. Pretty early Tech 2 Naval Rush from Killer. That should be interesting to see. Of course, Flying probably already knows. Usually has really good eco, and actually is bombing those engineers. He just killed a bunch of engineers right here with his Tech 1 bombers. So if anybody can match Killer, it's probably going to be Flying from Beach. Already has two Tech 1 naval, going for a Tech 2 naval. He definitely spotted the Tech 2 naval factory from Killer. And in the middle, Mama-san pushing quite hard with his Seraphim Arty. And at range, this is very effective. TX back out of the water, 6 kills. The ACU from Mama-san are getting some upgrades. Looks like it's the regeneration, so that was still quite popular to use. But after a while, there was a very specific rule. The only players allowed to do it is Affleck, and only if he comes back from under 1,000, under 100 health, then he can get it. Otherwise, it was illegal. But I think early 2010, it was allowed for anybody.
So let's see. Looks like the island is belongs to Ukulele. He's got Tech 2 Navy. No Tech 1 at all, a destroyer, a cruiser, and now a submarine. A destroyer, multiple destroyers for foaling. And both back players now with ASF. Eco cleaning up, and we can see multiple Tech 2, no resource allocation. Third Tech 3, and nice ASF panel, although not too much build capacity, only a single factory making engineers. Here come up minute 13. So Berg, quite a few more factories making NGs. He's got multiple Tech 2 getting on a Tech 3. No resource allocation either. Tech 2 land from Mamasun. But it's for the most part a stalemate in the middle. And now of course the shields from Aeon for a while, these were the best unit. Actually, they're still the best unit in the game, but for a while they ruled all of Navy. We're seeing EEF versus Cybern. Of course, Cybern can outrange. Now, one thing to notice here, both players using Tech 1, Tech 2. And of course, Tech 1 became really important to counter shields. We just might see that in this one. No Tech 2 whatsoever, Tech 1 whatsoever from Foley, completely destroys. But it doesn't look good for him against Ukulele. And now Flying putting a lot of pressure on Killer. Of course, Killer now going to use the second best combo. EEF plus Cybern. Cybern plus AN is better. We're going to see torpedo bombers from Killer trying to recover. But this Cyber Navy so far, pretty dominant, taking out shields, using the range. And really not much chance. Surprising that it's a cruiser and not a destroyer for Killer. Killer losing a few engineers. And we got the ASF battle. See, Berg definitely knows the Micro. I believe that's about 2009-2010 when the Micro was figured out. And here's the best combo in the game that's currently looked down upon. But this, you can't really do better than this. Aeon shield plus a Cybern destroyer. We've got a completely Aeon Navy here. Perhaps he'll get a little bit of Cybern help as well. And EEF Navy looks like planned for Foley. And looks like Berg, in terms of air, completely dominating. Got a whole bunch of torpedo bombers that's going to help out. Cybern torpedo bombers very effective. You can see his build capacity. He's actually stopped air production. So he's going to tech for a little while. So not giving Eco any respect. Eco getting his second Tech 3 power. Really needs to get a little more build capacity around that factory. Flying still. This is a standard Cybern build. You may have seen this from recent games from Zoc. This is the way he beat Sith. Of course, he did not mix Navy like this. And this is minute 20, so I guess by today's standards you should have mostly Tech 3 mass extractors at this point. Still for the most part Tech 2 from Flying, and that's always a pretty good battle early on here between Killer. A lot more Navy instead of just the standoff, which is what we're seeing now. In the other ocean we got Cybern together with EEF versus Aeon. It's a very good matchup, but looks like Ukulele is going to use Tech 1 and Tech 2 subs to get underneath the shields. Shields have to retreat. You never want to turn your back with Cyber Navy. Some torpedo bombers helping out, and a whole bunch of torpedo bombers from Killer. Going to try to snipe a couple of those destroyers. Blazes in here as well. But total air domination, which is makes it very difficult for Ukulele. It looks like Ukulele is going to give up and just retreat. He lost all his Tech 2 ships. All he's got left is ships, but now he does have Cybern, so he's going to have a nice combo just like Flying. In the middle, some Arty from TX. That's kind of strange. And Tech 3 power from Mama. And multiple Tech 3 air factories now for Eco is getting even more Tech 3 power. Still sort of keeping his base all clumped up. Berg definitely has a lot more energy on his factories, plus a whole bunch of hives, but he keeps on stopping his production. And has walked over to his pond. If you want to find Berg on Settings, look in this pond. Chances are you're going to find him. Mama, still with his regen, is going to start a chicken here in minute 23. And Berg's still dominating air versus Eco. Versus Echo, I guess. And this combo for ukulele, not surviving very well against that dominant air from Berg. Plus Killer sent a whole bunch of torpedo bombers as well. And actually Foley able to use his UEF shields, four UEF shields, keeping his destroyers alive. And this could be very bad for ukulele, even though he did look like the better player early on, but now he's losing because his team lost air. We still gotta save a little better eco for Mama than the mid player, but if Killer is able to break through flying, which doesn't look like he will, flying extremely good beach player, but this could be very dangerous for the bottom side if they lose both oceans. Doesn't look like there's really a way back for ukulele. He's already building a whole bunch of shields to try to protect his main base. He will eventually lose his island. It's a couple Tech 2 mass extractors, mostly Tech 1. These engines should just reclaim all this. And pretty massive air spam here from Berg, minute 26. Torpedo bomber still coming out for Eco. But of course this is quite late for torpedo bombers. They're very good in combination with Navy, but against shields, no chance. We're going to see ukulele trying to use the shields, and of course Cyber and Navy with that long range, and when you can't kill them with air, they reach really deep, can't protect against them with TMD. And with direct fire, ukulele, desperate measures. And is there any cruisers here? If the cruisers can be switched to really dominate against the shield, sort some artillery for ukulele. This is a Tech 3 ACU doing a good job. Perhaps a GC for ukulele there could break those shields, but nothing less than that. We might see a pretty big air battle now between Berg. Looks like Flying made a bunch of air as well. This is not what you want to do, just leave your air patrolling like that for Berg to come in and beat you. And actually, Berg, this is not like Berg at all. He just got hit really hard there. And this might even out the battle. Looks like the top side just took air. A little help from Flying for Eco and for Echo. Looks like Echo got a massive Eco and has multiple factories making air. One thing Flying is doing, spreading out his Tech 3 power generator, getting anti-nuke. Still has decent naval production, is really using those AN shields extremely well. And here comes the battle. The best combo versus the second best combo. You see UEF destroyers together with Cybern. Frigates moving in. They gotta try to get frigates underneath these shields. And looks like the shields for a Killer knocked down completely here. Some Tech 2 bombers from Killer as well trying to break the shields. Now we are seeing the victory for those AN shields there. So many of them you can pack. Stuff still definitely not old, but Riptides are now going to come in, try to get underneath. And actually, maybe I spoke too soon. Those Riptides are really going to turn the battle in Killer's favor. Looks like Berg is back for a little more, but yeah. So both teams definitely have a good air force still. Chicken is done for Mama. And that was a very clear victory for Killer. He can start moving in with his combo Navy, some strat bombers for Echo. Should be desperate measures here for Flying, making some cruisers. Be nice to see more NGs on that Tech 2 factory. And of course, the silent. I can't believe Ukulele actually upgraded those. Skellige is gonna lose them. Now we are seeing Foley. Looks like he gave his units over to Berg and is most likely gonna quit. Perhaps he had to leave for whatever reason. Maybe he lagged. He probably got falsely accused of lagging when it was actually Mama-san. Bet you about 80% that that's what happened. We see Tech 2 bombers for flying, but here come the Riptides. And this will be very difficult for flying. He does have harms. Those could keep you alive with Cybern for a while. Tech 3 ACU. Tech 2 bombers and a bit unorganized here for Killer. He is gonna do a lot of damage, but he's losing those shields. He's lost quite a few shields actually, so Tech 2 bombers for flying doing the job. But his production is gonna be in bad shape, but here comes the GC. It's gonna help Pat clean up against those Riptides. This would be a great target for the Riptides as well. But no more naval production for flying except a few harms. Berg did get a pretty good eco and a nice navy, actually maybe not a very good eco, a whole bunch of Tech 1 mask extractors. And he's still spamming shields like crazy here. Shields and UEF cruisers. And the chicken actually through the middle is just got taken out, kind of missed that battle, but it was a UEF. The fatty countered the chicken and a whole bunch of Ilshevas running through. They should probably turn around. There's nothing for them to do here. And Mamina helping his team, making a whole bunch of torpedo bombers, but they're Seraphim. This is a nice build capacity for air for Mamasan. Now we're going to see a pretty big air battle now here, minute 33. Now flying is continuing to counter. Bombing the NGs, he's going to try to stop the production for Killer because his naval production is pretty much a single tech factory now. And this GC, after taking care of the problem, is probably going to attack Killer. Berg trying to put pressure on Mama-san in the middle, who has got an anti-nig but Seraphim shields, more Seraphim shields, and plenty of TMD. Experimental now for Ukulele, who's actually survived by in spite of losing Navy. He's got a whole bunch of artillery here. Plenty of shields. He's going to get a nice Tech 3 air spam. And somehow he still held on to that island. Total air domination by Eco. And here come by Echo. And here come 5 Strat Bombers. And they break down 1 shield. But they won't make it too far past because there's a whole bunch of Tech 3 onto air for a Killer. Very impressive from Echo there with his air. He's actually got a bunch of staging to refuel his planes. And a nuke, which I completely missed here, minute 35. Nuke from Berg, let's see if that's successful. Looks like a GC for Ukulele is trying to counter this navy. Trying to break through the shields can be very difficult to do. One thing to note, minute 36, absolutely no Tech 3 yet. And that's going to be a successful nuke from Berg, very timely. There was an anti-nuke for Mama, but was not loaded yet. That's pretty nice, and a fatty coming in for TX. He's got to be careful not to get close to that GC. And here's this chicken from Mama-san, made it all the way across, and a GC, so two experimentals to deal with for Killer. Makes it out of the water, it's probably going to clean up on a few of these ships, and this should give Flying the time necessary to rebuild his navy. He is making a whole bunch of hives. Strat bombers for Berg. 65 kills on that nuke. And this GC is going to make out of the water nearly full health. And we're gonna see killer here out the back door, a whole bunch of tech 3 PD, the chicken's dead. The chicken's gonna have to, the GC's gonna have to avoid the chicken. But air support for the GC, and he walks around in the circle. Strap bombers for Berg. Berg not wanting this fight, although this is a pretty good position to fight in. This is not good for the GC, he's got to wait for that to stop doing its thing. And now once again, Ukulele is under attack, he does have a megalith. But with so many cruisers shooting from far away, you can't imagine those shields holding for too long. And here comes the air battle. People definitely putting their planes on out of fire here. It would be hard to believe Eco actually winning this one. He's completely retreating, getting hit in the back, and this is what happens when you retreat like that. A turn now for Eco, trying to get behind Berg, and actually looks like he does, but now it is numbers advantage for Berg, and Berg is going to take air back. A massive Tech 2 bomber spam here from flying. This is a lot of hives. This is impressive construction here from flying. Ukulele surviving, trying to rebuild the navy, and actually might be well, as soon as that navy moves over, this is all going to be gone. And somehow a single cruiser could have already taken care of all that mass. It's plus 6 times 5, so that's 30 mass a second that Ukulele is getting that he shouldn't be. Now this GC actually makes it through, probably walked by Berg here. And broadswords for killer. It would be nice to just use these drones to reclaim it, but it's gunships, and this can be a nice chunk of mass for killer. And Tech 3 Navy now for killer. So Tech 3 Navy used plus a megalith. This is a perfect time of it. It's just about when experimentals come out, maybe a little after. Yet another ASF battle, but this time looks like Eco might be successful. But of course, Berg flying over a whole bunch of cruisers of his ally. Also ASF here from TX. Mama Sun getting a transport, flying away. Perhaps he finally figured out he's the lagger, so he asked him to leave. Fatty with 40 kills, putting a lot of pressure on Mama. Mama nearly done with the chicken. He's also got an anti-nuke there. Would be still not loaded, but it sucked to lose that against the Fatty. Fatty together with a whole bunch of Percys. And of course this Navy in support, so a lot of danger for this middle base, for the top side. Looks like Mama has escaped, got himself a shield. Chicken has been completed and is going to try to fix the Fatty problem. Although against that many Percys it might be difficult, and the Navy. And now the Mega is going to try to keep this naval production alive for Ukulele. Ukulele getting more shields.
And now finally, probably by accident, this island is going to be lost for Ukulele. See a whole bunch of torpedo bombers for Berg. Berg should have another nuke nearly loaded. Yeah, he already has it loaded. Not clear why he hasn't shot that yet. It'd be nice to nuke right there so that TX can just walk in. Strat bombers for Eco. He might just move in here. So one thing that's interesting, we've seen a lot of air fights in this game here at 43 minutes, but neither side really lost air. Comes Mama. Fatty gets bombed. Now Chicken versus Percys. Percys are quite dangerous versus experimentals, so are gonna get the job done. They just gotta run away now. Here, Mega having some success against this shielded Navy. Gunships for killer. So you can see Berg Navy, Tech to Navy, and ASF. That's where most of his build capacity is going, plus the nuke, which he's not using. But now this anti nuke is loaded. Perhaps he thought it was loaded, but it just got loaded. He could have definitely killed it. And here comes the nuke from Berg. Let's see where that flies. That could be against ukulele. But he's got a nuke here. Anti-nuke. It might be against naval production. Looks like he is pointing that that's where he's nuking. And that's going to make it really easy for his Navy. It's a good use of a nuke from Berg. Now I'm getting a little more eco. And a Mega now for Mama in the middle. See a lot of tech mixing here at minute 44. A Mega for killer as well. There goes the nuke. Some of the Navy survives, but there's no more production. Mega survives, trying to stay in shallow water. Somebody should drop that island, pick up the three mass extractors. TX with a shield. Nice air spam. Would expect them to have an anti-nuke here somewhere. Another Mega for Mama playing defense. He's got many different problems. Another Mega for flying. Flying nearly lost his entire Navy, but was able to come back with the air help from Eco. It looks like Killer's back for more. This time he's brought a Megalith with him. But if flying can get a Mega of his own, plus there's a whole bunch of Harbs here, so this will be extremely difficult to break. Of course, also anti-nukes, two anti-nukes loaded. So flying, really the biggest problem. He's got a whole bunch of deck 3 power. Perhaps flying might be thinking of getting a teleport. I'm pretty sure that's exactly what he's getting. Yeah, that's exactly what he's getting. That's gonna make this game very interesting once flying start teleporting. Another massive air battle. Berg, well, actually it's not clear. Both Eco and Berg have been very even in this one. But through the middle, multiple fatties. Mega trying to play defense. It's now at plus zero. Berg using some crazy micro here, splitting up his forces into two. Now they recombine. That was a looks like it's gonna be a pretty good turn there from Eco. We're gonna see this Mega respect the harms. Flying getting yet another upgrade. This is gonna be the laser. So now we're gonna have to see if there are any possible targets. And nuke from Eco. So a return nuke, and I did not see any anti-nukes for TX, but I may have just missed it. No, he's got an anti-nuke with four anti-nukes right there, but this is a good target. Does Killer have an anti-nuke? Yeah, he's got an anti-nuke as well, perhaps Killer's Island. It looks like it is flying toward the Navy, but a Berg getting out of the way, so kills couple of units, but maybe a bit of a waste on that nuke. Could have nuked this production. You could clearly take him back the island, so I guess if they're not going to attack you for about 20 minutes, might as well take you back. Mega for 15 kills for Mama Sun, but let's see what the ACUs are. So Berg is in the pond, he's not a target. Definitely don't want to teleport here. Nuke now for Killer. Ravagers would kill you very quickly. TX got a shield, So that's probably not an ACU you want to teleport against. Take a long time to kill even with a laser. Might actually pull it off, but it'll be very dangerous. So let's see where Flying decides to fly to. He could teleport, well, even here would probably be pretty dangerous. An anti-nuke being constructed now by Killer. But he could teleport in the back, perhaps make some secret bases to do some sniping. But that's always a dangerous thing to do. It could be a nice desperation move. But there goes the Mega, and now the Fatties can start rolling through. Plus the Mega for Killer decided not to go through the water. He's going to go through the top. So the top side has some problems about what to do in the middle. Ukulele is going to try to get a Navy going from underneath these shields. MT extending on the edge of water and land here. You can always go in either direction depending on what they're attacking you with. Berg is going to get some tele protection. He's going to get a whole bunch of torpedo launchers, so you don't want to go in there if you're flying. And Flying actually goes into the island. And with the laser, takes out Tech 3 mask extractors. See how long he stays before he leaves. Takes out the anti-nuke, gets a point defense going. Now it looks like he is going to be getting out. Should expect a response here from Killer, but doesn't really look like he's going to leave a point defense with him. Point defense behind. Be nice to kill that factory before he leaves, but he doesn't do it. This point defense should be killing that factory. That way no artillery is made. That way this point defense can stay alive. Now Mega versus Tech 3 Navy. The Mega from Killer running through Mama Sun's base, but this anti-nuke is still alive, but maybe not for long. The spider's probably gonna attack it. No, it's actually a spider that's on this side. I was just tripping there. Successful defense for Mama keeps his anti-nuke. Clearly making cruisers. He's got a nice shield spam here, so as soon as he gets a Navy, he's going to get a lot of shields on it. Still a very even game here at minute 50. Eco's got yet another nuclear launcher. He's almost got the other one loaded. It was 8 kills last time. Remember Killer was making a nuke. He's already finished it. Got a shield in his ACU. So Killer versus Flying here. Extremely even game. And now we're going to see Mech Marines versus Point Defense. This shield's keeping it alive. Maybe this will be the only time in history that a Mech Marine was able to kill a Point Defense, but he's got nice protection. Yet another nuke now for Eco. Or Echo. I'll keep messing that one up. Really can't see where it's the game is going to be lost for either side. Definitely an advantage in Navy here for Berg. But Ukulele should have probably lost a long time ago. He's getting more Tech 3 shields. And if he gets a couple more experimentals here, maybe a couple harms would be nice for him. The nuke goes into the middle. Not sure how many kills that got him. He got another 10. Just saw some gunships from Berg. He stopped his production. Perhaps he's getting... Nope. The ukulele could be in trouble. And perhaps finally, about 30 minutes later, that naval victory for the bottom side is gonna pay off. It could be the beginning of the end for Ukulele. Ukulele using the hives to reclaim some destroyers. Their artillery is going to work. So pretty dangerous for ukulele if this keeps firing. Not much that he can do. Some Tech 2 bombers for Mama. Chicken for Mama. More shields. Looks like I missed like about a minute there by this attack from ukulele. Was able to defend with a mega, but multiple battleships from Berg. We'll see how that turns out. So really, once ukulele falls to this navy, which he should eventually, this game should be getting wrapped up. Berg for long periods in this game had absolutely nothing coming from this factory. Not really sure why that is. Forgot the infinite build button. The mega for flying, having to retreat against subs, although this, the torpedoes on this are quite nice. We're seeing the Tech 3 Navy, and I guess Tech 3 Navy has its place right here. As right before the Tech 3 T4 game enders, has a huge effect. It's after a long Tech 2 naval fight, the battleships come in to clean up, and here comes a nuke from Eco, and this just might be against this navy. We see Berg is probably going to try to get out, but battleships are very slow to react. We see Berg moving out in different directions, and he just might be quick enough. Pretty massive ASF battle as well, and I'm actually at minus two. That's pretty crazy. I guess that's what happens. I guess I'm gonna have to wait a little longer for a strange animation there on that nuke. Just like fell into the water. But a multicolored ASF battle once again. Mega is destroyed here for ukulele, but I'm hoping after this battle's done, some speed will go up. So on the box for this game, the minimum requirements are a single core 3 gigahertz processor. And now I have a quad at 4.5, so they got those wrong, at least for this game. But you can see after after that air fight's done, the sim speed is going back up at plus one. Another mega coming in for ukulele to play some defense against all these battleships. And this is really what a battleship is supposed to do: break a turtle like this. It's not meant to be a 1v1 battle here. Another battleship, this one's the EEF one. This one's got a little longer range than the Cybern. A little more health as well. This one's gonna try to break this turtle that Mama's made. And now another nuke. This one's from flying. Let's see where he sends this one. It's probably Killer's Navy is going to try to dodge this one as well. And now Berg has found a whole bunch of torpedo bombers.
Oh, it looks like this nuke is going straight past the Navy. At the naval production. Yeah, that's the regular animation for a water nuke, unlike the one that happened over here. Another mega. Ukulele should probably start working on yet another. We've seen a whole bunch of artillery for Mama's son trying to break the shields, but now it's going to be this base going to be taking hits from both sides. Double mega for flying. These nukes just keep on being launched all the time. And once again, both Berg and Killer have to react to it, so they're moving their navies away. And that does buy the shields a bit of time to try to recover. So we know that Flying has had his teleport for the longest time, which he seems to have not been using. I see Berg here with a teleport defense. And this nuke for Killer is also nearly nearly finished. Looks like the top side is attacking the naval production for the bottom side. Whole bunch of strats not coming in for ukulele, and an experimental nuclear launcher here for Mama's son. So T4 game under this right here. Takes about 300,000 mass, a little under. So to compare that to, say, an experimental like the megalith, which I believe takes about 50,000, so it's about 6 megaliths for this structure right here. But if people keep gifting each other dead experimentals, it is definitely possible. It's a lot more possible now with the naval wrecks on Forge Alliance Forever. If you just pick up all that mass, you almost have conservation of mass now on Forge Alliance Forever. Unless you get overkills or noobs. Pretty crazy submarine fight here, a whole bunch of subs. And actually very even numbers, but this shield is definitely gonna help for Killer, but the double megalith. Very good torpedoes on those as well. Can't break the turtle, this is now four battleships. Eventually it should fall, however, but if it doesn't fall before that experimental by Mama-san, which is already halfway done, and that's going to be a very good anti-naval weapon, I imagine. Here we're just past 1 hour. Don't really see anything, any experimentals like that for Killer. He's got an anti-nuke here, very good production. This is the way to build stuff here, UEF. But his ACU is just making more T3 power for TX-1000. He's basically just got production of his own. Remember, he's got an anti-nuke here, 7 anti-nukes. That's going to buy him a lot of time against the experimental. And ukulele is still surviving with his Tech 3 shields, and T3 ACU makes those Tech 2 so quickly. This one's from Killer. Let's see where that lands. It looks like in this battle, Killer is the winner. The shields pay off, and he's got a megalith of his own, so that's not surprising. So once again, we're seeing Navy being the deciding factor, at least unless this makes a huge impact. Looks like this nuke and try to follow it is gonna land on those on those Tech 3 mass extractors. You can see the nukes are always in a higher plane than all the planes. You can also have satellites. There's some mods we can have satellite warfare. Think there was a debate which game has better nukes, World at Conflict, at War, or whatever. World in Conflict or Supreme Commander. That's a pretty silly discussion. Ukulele still surviving, just rebuilding shields. Can't imagine how fast this game was going when they're actually playing it. Hey, we got yet another air battle. Minus five. I think it's pretty ridiculous. I think it's actually minus six now. See, I was looking for a game to lag my new computer. I've definitely found it. This megalith is also gonna die. But whoever wins this one's gonna have a pretty big prize. But I gotta say, it looks like it's gonna be the top side. So navy to the bottom and air to the top, and an experimental nuke for Mama Sun. It's gonna be a question whether or not this navy can go in hard enough to kill that experimental nuke before that experimental nuke wins the game. Berg's still staying alive. Actually, maybe I called it too early. There's still a lot of ASF here for killer. And actually, looks like Killer and Berg might just take this one. Back at zero. So that's nice. That should really speed this game up. See if any more harms for flying. Quite a few shields playing defense, and of course the perimeter monitoring. That's always nice in battles. And I don't think ukulele's ever gonna get killed. It's gonna take a lot more battleships. So the air has been taken by the bottom side, which is a very bad situation. In the middle, we also have a whole bunch of Percys. And now strat bombers plus gunships for a killer. They just might be looking at that. There's a lot of Tech 3 anti-air for the bottom side, and here we're seeing something special. The Harms playing defense. Well, this megalith, once it comes out of the water, it's going to be quite devastating. You should see experimentals like this chicken getting a lot closer, plus more shields. Unless this gets finished and can be used defensively, which would just be amazing. I really hope that happens. I've seen Berg and Killer trying to prevent any more construction. Tech 3 anti-air for Eco or Echo. But now multiple megaliths for ukulele. The Harm's actually getting overpowered here by so many T2 subs. The cruisers at their long range plus the battleships. It is now finished. We just might see this at work. Strat bombers coming in from Killer. I want to see the nuke hit right here. If that happens, this will make this game so awesome. With strat bombers flying all over the place, they are definitely doing damage, but engineers are not that big a deal. Mama Sun needs to get a lot more build capacity on this. Get those out quicker. Torpedo bombers trying to kill Berg, almost missed this. Berg's got to be very careful. Gets out just in time. That was a sneaky move there by flying. This should be finished. More build capacity on it now. And it should hit right there and completely turn this game on its head. Let's see here, 1 hour, 7 minutes. It is not being launched by Mama Sun. He doesn't know what to do. Does he realize he has this? And which one? And it's actually Echo's shooting his nuke. Why is Mama Sun not using it yet? Here it is. Let's see where that goes. This did cause Killer to retreat. Flying went in with a teleport, a bit of desperation. And that was the defensive nuke from Echo. Flying trying to kill Berg. Berg still with 1500 health. And but of course it's going to take quite a few nukes against this base of Killer to break through. We should see another one on its way. But I'd really love to see that defensive nuke. Perhaps a little too much desperation there from Flying. But now a whole bunch of strat bombers coming in from TX. And of course those strat bombers are definitely going to shift this turtle. We cannot stand against strat bombers and battleships. And Ukulele gets sniped. So this is now a 2v4. Very well played by Ukulele, but he just he's been playing defense this entire game. We see a nuclear sub here. Mama Sun is still going after Killer's base. It's anti-nuke, has absolutely no anti-nukes left. Killer has to be pretty worried at this point. He's got another one over here, but a couple nukes here and this could be a 2v2 game once again. In the middle, some trouble. Because Mama Sun and Echo are definitely capable players. Here comes a nuke now from Echo. And that's a very nice spam from Berg, a whole bunch of torpedo bombers. He's probably looking for any ECUs hiding in pawns. And I'm expecting some of these nukes to actually begin landing. It's another defensive nuke. Couple battleships get sunk. Relatively minor damage and nuke now from Killer. Killer running, realizing he's probably screwed, and this is going to be a very devastating nuke. It looks like, well, it is gonna, there goes one on, oh my gosh, that's so close. This anti-nuke with zero missiles left gets the job done. And that's just not good. Mama Sun still has it loaded and needs to launch it. This is gonna go down to the wire, it seems. More shields to protect the nuke. Mama Sun playing great defense in the middle, but Berg's Navy now going to work on his middle turtle. No more anti-nukes for Killer. Berg running. So Killer and Berg are about to lose this base. And there it is. Should be quite a few kills. Killer gets out just in time. It's a couple more like that and this game will be even. We'll actually see a nuclear sub, almost never see these. Should be tricky, let's see where that hits. It's loaded once again, should be launched. No reason to wait, just launch it. Hit right there. Let's see if this nuke actually it looks like strat bombers now. Oh, that was pretty amazing. That nuke has just hit one of the planes flying over it and exploded over Mama's son's game. So since everything is simulated, that does happen. If you're desperate for anti-nukes, you just fly over the launcher with a whole bunch of your planes, and this game ends in pretty crazy fashion. I hope people enjoyed this one. I definitely did.